All right, what's up, everyone? Duquesne23 here, and we are here for another, but not another. I'm not starting over in the number wise. So this is still, I don't know, number 26 or something like that. I forget what it is. But this is going to be now on Sunday, and we're going to call it Q&A Sunday. So
we'll see if we can stick to that.
Well, the reason why is it was tough. Whenever we did Famo Fridays, we would record it on Thursday so I can upload it on Friday. And it was tough to do that because she has to wake up early in the morning. So, of course, that means she would have to stay up later to be able to do this.
But it wasn't always me. Like, if we have errands to run or something on a weekday, we're doing it after
It was always real tight and stuff. So that, you know, we have to put Aiden to bed and everything. We can't do it right after. The only time we can record it after Aiden goes to bed is probably like an hour later once he's asleep. And by that time, she's really tired and she doesn't get that much sleep. So that's the reason why we decided to change it to Sunday. This way, we can record it on either a Saturday or a Friday night or something like that. Or even a Sunday if we have the time.
We have all weekend. So, yeah, so we have
multiple days to be able to record it.
So we'll see. We'll try to stick with this one.
We'll try to stick with this one, but yeah. And we'll see how that is.
Bear with us.
But all right, guys. The first question we have is from the Purple Leprechaun.
Good color.
Yeah.
Nice color.
You know, blue's better, but okay. No,
purple's the best.
Oh, before we get into this, I just saw it. Look at my lovely shirt, everyone. Daily routine. Heat, sleep, forge. Pretty good shirt. You can get this in the link below in the description if you want to. But yeah, I actually, you know, put a few new designs for, you know, my Duquesne 23. This one, I actually have some other ones in mind that I will be putting up there pretty soon, related to Halo, like Forge type of things and everything, since that's kind of what I like.
You have some good ideas for some t-shirts, so you need to get on there and make them.
Also, guys, I'm really excited about this.
And then y'all can go get them.
I'm not saying anything because I don't want anyone to know. I want it to be a complete surprise. I'm not even telling Beowulf, which Beowulf, I tell a lot of things, you know, that if I like have an idea about something, I'm not even going to tell him about this. But I have an unbelievable idea for Halo 2 Anniversary's Forge.
Now, was it your idea?
It was not my idea, though. I expanded upon it a little bit on some of the deals, but you know, the initial idea
was actually a collaboration
between me and Eli Whitney, which, in case y'all don't know, is my Asian friend. And he's he's my real life friend. He's like my only friend that I still talk to from high school and stuff. And so he had a great idea and everything, and he doesn't really forge and stuff. So you know, he threw that idea to me, and it is unbelievable. I'm not even joking, guys. This is a game changer. This is a game changer. It is unbelievable idea. Like it's never been done before. It's amazing. I'm so excited about it. Can't wait for it.
Okay. This will really be his routine.
Yes, it will. No joke. That will be my routine whenever messaging
comes up. Except for the middle one will probably go away almost completely.
Well, not really too much eat. It's maybe half eat. It'll be like be just constantly eating snacks.
It'll be half eat, no sleep, all forge.
All forge. There we go. Maybe I should make a shirt about that. Happy, sleep, all forge.
Okay.
But all right, guys, let's get to these questions. First question is, says, hey, guys, my question is for both of you. Name a food or food topping that you like,
but
others find it weird. Sorry about that, messing up. I asked this question because I like to mix ranch dressing with my rice and most people I know find that kind of weird. So yeah, thanks. She had to say rice because he typoed and said rise, but it was just a typo.
Did you just want to make sure they knew I wasn't correct?
Well, yeah, because I'm too dumb to be able to say rice, you know, or something, you know. R-I-C-E, Andrew.
I eat a lot of weird stuff.
Yeah, but together, though? I guess this may not be weird, but what
it's a weird food or a weird food topping.
Maybe, possibly, you find this weird. I mix mustard and ketchup to eat my corn dogs with.
No, I don't find that weird at all.
I thought you find that weird.
No.
Oh, never mind.
It's perfectly natural.
Never mind. I eat a ridiculous amount of Oreos in one sitting.
I like ranch with pizza, but that's, I think that's a lot of people.
That's a normal thing.
I think a lot of people, I think a lot of people use ranch on a lot of stuff.
I'm trying to think. I don't know if there's anything really.
I like buttermilk sauce on my Jack in the Box tacos. Would people find that weird?
No, I don't know.
But it's like ranch.
It's like ranch. Buttermilk is pretty much ranch.
It's like ranch really goes with anything.
Yeah, and so this is something I don't think
I don't know what kind of rice
whenever
is
I was
this.
Younger,
is this white, just steamed white
rice? I think so.
Rice?
Yeah, I think so.
I wonder if that's what he means or if he means like
okay,
fried
but
rice or
this is
brown rice.
Well, he would have probably said that, you know, not just rice. But I don't think I've had this with you. Oh, no, I have once. Since I've been with you and stuff. But whenever I was younger, I used to eat this all the time. A honey sandwich. Literally get a piece of bread, squirt honey on it, and put another piece of bread on top, and that's it.
Something that your parents do that I like is butter and honey on a tortilla. On a homemade,
yeah.
Warm. It has to be.
It's really good.
Because I don't really like tortillas, but if you go to like a tortilla factory,
yeah, but a lot of people
or some
do
place
that.
Where it's homemade, butter and honey.
Yeah, but that's
I had
not
never
something
heard
that's
of that
weird,
before.
Though. Yeah, but people
well,
would be like, that's
that.
Weird. People would be like, that.
Your parents introduced
amazing.
Me to that, like putting butter, honey,
yeah,
and wrapping
so.
It, and that's your...
I don't know if we have anything really,
really
weird, like the ranch and rice. That's,
I'm sure,
that's
sure
really,
we do, but I'm just not thinking of it.
That probably tastes pretty good, but ranch and rice, that's something that's really drastically different type of thing.
Yeah, that
so,
is.
Okay.
It will, if we do have something like that, it's not something that we eat a lot of.
Yeah, because we can't think of it off
like,
the top
yeah,
of our
we
head.
We probably do eat weird things,
yeah.
But it's
I don't, yeah,
not
I don't
that
know.
Often. So
I don't know.
If we think of something,
the weird
we'll
thing,
have to add
I my weird thing is I eat a package of Oreos in one sitting normally.
That's not weird. Well,
that's weird.
Not weird. It's just unhealthy.
That's an issue.
Yes, that's
an issue.
That's just a problem.
That is an issue.
Yeah.
But okay, so let's go into the next question.
Oh, I know what.
What?
Some people find this weird. Whenever I used to eat ramen noodles all the time,
okay,
ramen noodles,
I
would crack an egg. No, you're thinking of a different one.
No, I'm thinking of
I would crack an egg into my ramen noodles and stir it in so it'd be like scrambled eggs. But I mean, if you really think about it, it's not that weird because whenever you get like
fried rice
or lo mein or something from a Chinese restaurant, it has eggs. So. But some people do find it weird. And I put cheese. I stick a slice of cheese in my creamy chicken ramen noodles.
Yeah.
Those are the only two.
That tastes amazing.
Those are the only two flavors I alter.
If you eat ramen noodles and, you know, eat creamy chicken, put a slice of cheese in it.
And don't mix it too much. Because if you just mix it in too much, then it's just creamier.
But
if you mix it where you're leaving chunks of cheese.
Try not to hit things.
Then while you're eating, you'll get like that chunk.
But first, before you do that though, you have to drain out all the water out of it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, there's certain ramen noodles where you like a little bit of water in it. But with
this
the creamy chicken, you take out all the water,
put your
piece of cheese in there and stuff. Oh, it's so good.
And then just kind of fold the cheese in.
Yeah, it's good.
And let it just kind of melt. But then it's like that chunky melt.
It's good. It's good.
It's good.
But okay, so we're going to the next one. Bryce Jr., he asked, Duquesne, what got you into YouTube? Halo. Halo got me into YouTube pretty much. It was during Reach and stuff. I didn't really do anything type of YouTube or even custom maps. I didn't forge at all in Halo 3, really. I think I made like a total of 3 maps and they're all really crappy. And but whenever Reach came out, I started forging a lot. I got into YouTube just because I wanted to just post my maps on YouTube so people could download them. Mm-hmm. You know, just get my maps out there and be like, oh, I made this cool map and, you know, I hope people want to download it and stuff. And that's what got me started. And then it picked up whenever I think Deranker owned Forge World Maps and he doesn't own it anymore and stuff. But whenever owned Forge World Maps, he did a top 5, little contest type of thing on race maps. And I was number 2 and it was my Tokyo Drift map. That was number 2. A lot of people like that map, and I absolutely hate that map.
No, I thought there was another big YouTuber that had your Tokyo Drift as a number 1 map. Out of the top 10.
That was some, I don't remember, but that was my breakout.
You kind of were like, well, you know, I like making these videos and I like, and it became kind of.
It's just pretty much, I did it so people would go download my maps and stuff. Because
like
I did a lot of theme things.
You just wanted to get the word out about your maps. Like, hey,
and
I
just started picking up. And that's what really, but that, you know, contest where I got second is what really caused people, because he had like 10,000 subscribers. Then, and that was a lot, you know.
And that kind of made you want to do like the whole top five and and you kind of got into doing all that
and
stuff.
And the thing is, there's something else I might bring back since, because Halo 4's custom games were dead pretty much. And but Master Chief Collection, with what they're doing, they're pretty much making everyone happy. And they're adding some really awesome things in there. And so it's going to come back. And so I might, you know, pick up a little contest again, you know, and stuff, and just give away something, you know, that I have or whatever.
You know what I should have said with the food?
She's always on food, guys.
Andrew makes fun of me for being a country girl, but I grew up with grits. I don't like grits at all. I grew up eating rabbit, squirrel, dove.
Good. That's good. But grits, I don't like grits at all.
I don't find that stuff weird, like, but grits. I guess whenever I meet other people, if I mention anything about eating animals like that, that they're not accustomed to eating, they find that really weird.
But that is what got me into YouTube and just the enjoyment out of doing it. Guys, it's like, you know, I don't talk about this too much and everything, especially on video. Like, every once in a while, I'll talk about it with people in parties and stuff. It's, you know, that ask me questions. Like, I'll be doing a game night and someone will ask me a question or whatever. But, or on a stream. But really, on YouTube videos, like, the thing is, what I'm doing right now isn't even enough for, like, a part-time job and stuff like that. It's, you know, I'm a stay-at-home dad. That's my actual, like, job and stuff. So we don't, you know, because I enjoy staying home with Aiden. And we don't have to pay for, like, daycare and stuff.
And we have another one coming. And we really don't want to put, like, at Aiden's age, we wouldn't mind putting him in daycare. Yeah. But, you know, I don't want to put a six-week-old into daycare.
And to have two kids in daycare, that's like $2,000 a month.
And with the baby coming, you know, there's no point in, you know, you might as well just stay
and
home.
And so stay home, save that money. And also, like, I do this because I just enjoy it. I know even if I've told Jennifer, like, in the future, I'm going to have to get an actual job because I doubt this will pan out to where I can even, you know, pay.
Where it'll be like a full-time.
Where it'll be like a full-time job and stuff. So, but the deal is, I even told Jennifer, I'm never going to stop doing this. I enjoy it. Even if I come out with only one video a week, you know, or something like that, I still enjoy doing it. I just like putting, I like making videos. I like doing that. Of course, sometimes it could get stressful.
But it is your job right now. I mean, you work on it on a daily basis.
Well, yeah.
You might not make as much income as you would like, but, you know, it's still a job.
Yeah. And, but the deal is,
yeah,
with
you're
the,
right.
With
you're the stay-at-home
with
dad.
The Halo videos and stuff like that, like doing all the custom maps, I love looking at people's custom maps. I love posting those on there and stuff. That's
getting
why I cannot wait.
Out.
That's it. Yeah. And that's the thing. I was a small, you know, person that was unknown, and a bigger YouTube channel showcased my map. And that's what got me to where people know who
I,
like 343
like
knows
that
who
for
I am.
Other people.
And yeah, and that's
like
exactly.
If he sees a cool map, he's like, oh, I want people to, I want people to know about this
and,
person or about this map. This guy did a good job.
People talk to me about, like, hey, I've gotten questions about this. Like, why did you create Forge Channel? You know, because there's other things out there like Halo Customs, you know, where it does customs deals. It's very similar to Forge Channel. Like, I pretty much kind of based a lot of things off of Halo Customs and also from a few other sites, and I pulled them in. And the reason why I created it is because I wanted a place where I can showcase other people's maps. And Forge Channel is basically, I'm going to be doing contests on there, you know, starting with Master Chief Collection. Where, you know, I give away games and stuff like that, a Master Chief Collection, I give away, you know, like maybe some Microsoft points sometimes. But the thing is, like, I want to be able to showcase people's maps on the front page of that. So, like, really cool maps and everything. And also, you know, over Twitter, and also I'm going to, you know, be showcasing people's maps from Forge Channel, like on my own channel and like on my YouTube channel. And it's like that. I wanted it to be a place where unknown people, and of course known, can go and get bigger, like get more known. Because I was one of the people that started forging, and I wasn't getting any views or downloads or anything like that on my own. You know, like it just wasn't doing until that video.
Until other people started noticing.
That video that showcased me, a bigger channel, you know, showcased my map on that contest. And got the word out. And then people actually started looking me up and stuff, and it started getting bigger and bigger. So I want to do the same for other people. I want to do the same for people who are small, unknown forgers and stuff.
Yeah.
That's something that, you know.
You don't want their talent to go unnoticed.
Well, yeah,
because
there's some people who are unbelievable at making stuff. You know, and so that's why I want to do it, especially with the new Forge. But okay, next question. That was a long YouTube deal. But okay, so Yo Bean asked, do you have any, do you think any enemy in Destiny would be able to match the Vex?
And I mean what?
Like canonically, like in the canon of Destiny, okay. I'm guessing. I don't know. Vex, they can pretty much like teleport anywhere. They can like they're like robotic or whatever. It's a pretty beast of an enemy. But I don't know the Cabal though. They can like literally move worlds and stuff. If you look through all the like the stuff, the Grimoire or something, I don't know, whatever. I think Grimoire cards and stuff on Bungie.net and stuff. They can actually like the Cabal can like move worlds. They look very similar to the Cabal. I don't know if you remember in the Fifth Element at the very beginning, those big old big people. They look like exactly like that.
So that's your answer. You think possibly? Them?
I don't know. Yeah, they can move worlds and stuff. Yeah, pretty crazy. Yeah. But I don't really know too much about it. So man,
read the next one.
So lightsaber or force powers?
Both.
I have both.
That is a hard
force powers.
Yeah, of course.
Because if you don't have the ability to wield a lightsaber,
with the force powers, goes away. Like, what if somebody takes your lightsaber?
Well, that's the deal. You need the force powers to wield a lightsaber, like a Jedi can. You know, like because they have the quick reflexes, the movement, and everything because of the force powers, like their midichlorians and things like that.
I would much rather have force powers.
Yeah.
Do the
for sure. Yeah, or just be able to lift people up. Or
just say, hey.
With force powers, you can go like this and stop a shot.
You can say, hey, bag of Doritos.
Yeah.
Or
that'd be awesome.
Or Aiden could be running to the street and you can go.
Yeah, seriously. Yeah. Hold my hand, Aiden, with force powers.
You know, I have a little bone to pick with the whole Star Wars franchise overall. Like the movies, the cartoon, the TV show, everything. Because I get so mad sometimes because we're watching it and I'm like, oh my gosh, you have the ability to just
grab someone.
I mean, I know it's kind of overpowered and they don't want to use that too much. But it's like, come on, in reality,
it's the same reason in like superhero movies. Well, yeah. You can't go too much.
It's like, oh,
like even Superman and like even Captain America and Hulk. Like Hulk is ridiculously powerful, or you know.
But still, it's still kind of frustrating because it's like, come on.
Yeah.
If you had that ability, you would constantly be using it.
Yeah, there's so many times
they're fighting, and I'm like, yeah, you could just throw her across the room.
I think there was something recently we watched in the Clone Wars where a guy did a force push, and it pushed out like tons of droids that were in front of him. There's like 10 of them in front of him. It's like, why don't you do that
all the time?
Just sit there and just go boom, boom, boom.
I told him, I said, it's not like it's a video game where you have a power meter and you just used up your powers. Just keep using it.
And then there's people like in the games, like Starkiller, that can literally bring down a Star Destroyer out of the sky. And it's like, so there's no one else in the world that can bring down something that was crazy. Yeah, or like if there's a TIE fighter or even an X-Wing, if you're on, you know, a Sith or something, you know, like coming after you or whatever, it's like, you telling me you can't stop a
like,
TIE fighter.
They don't have an enemy running away, and it's like, you know, you just can go like just, this, go, you can whoop. Just stop them from going. It bugs me.
It's understandable because it would be too OP.
But at the same time, I know that would kind of kill it. You can't.
So
anyway, force powers.
So just telling you, all these questions are from Yo Bean. Next one is Reach versus 3, like Halo Reach versus Halo 3. That's tough because the Forge and Reach was unbelievably better than 3. But the multiplayer in 3 was way better than Reach.
But I was actually into multiplayer
in 3 a lot.
You just weren't really into the Forge that much during Halo 3. You kind of started into it. No, I was in it,
but the only way you could phase objects was that little glitch thing, and that was so annoying.
Whenever you made the tornado.
Yeah,
and that didn't you have
forever.
To build, and you had to build, because you couldn't.
Well, yeah, you can't make
you couldn't
items
build it
float
in the sky.
Air.
It had to be on something.
Yeah, on something.
So you had to build a tower up. and then you build on it, and then you had to delete everything underneath.
Yeah, and do the little glitch. Yeah,
I remember how much time you spent.
It was so annoying, and so that's why
that was your original.
I would have to say Reach because specifically the Forge. But if you're a multiplayer person, by far Halo 3. You know, but if you're a Forge customs, I would say
both.
Yeah, it depends.
But for you personally,
for me personally, Reach. It would be Reach because I'm more into Forge and stuff. But yeah. All right, so you should play the Shadow of Mordor. It's amazing. I have it, I play it, and it's awesome. Does the McDonald's in your country sell the McSpicy? Is that just a spicy chicken sandwich?
It probably is.
If so, I love it.
I'm assuming that's what the if you're not referring to the spicy chicken sandwich, you'll have to fill
us
in.
Guessing.
But I'm thinking that's what he means by McSpicy.
So, all right. So then, what's your favorite Halo 2 anniversary map? Bloodline. Not counting a Forge Canvas, because Awash is the newest Forge Canvas. It's the only one that we've seen. Oh, let me just explain this real quick. Some people have been confused by this. People think the Ascension Skybox is another Forge Canvas, like the Skybox, the second Forge Skybox. And that is not true. If you notice on the screenshots where they show the little one-by-one block, and also whenever they show the screenshots in Forge of them just showing all of Ascension, you could tell it's all the exact same object count number. So I think it's like 333 or something like that out of 650. So that's on the same map. It's still forging on Ascension. So we've only seen one skybox. You know, the Ascension, you know, Forge deal is not another skybox. Now they may have it later on. That is another skybox.
Did you make a video about
screenshots?
You made a video about the
skybox.
It's just called Awash.
Awash. Yeah, I made a video about it. Breakdown
and
analysis video.
Did you explain that in that?
No. Okay. I may make some side videos kind of explaining to help people realize like some of these
things. To catch things that you might have seen.
But okay, so what's your favorite Halo map? Like multiplayer map, it would have to be... I don't want to say a new one. It would, like, just because... I don't know. I would want to say Bloodline because I love Blood Gulch Coagulation, whatever stuff like that.
Let's not count that because you haven't played on it. Let's say one that you played on.
I don't know. I really love Terminal too. I love Turf also. I like Relic too. That's a good one. I don't know. I'm going to say I've never played any of the PC maps, so none of those can count. I would have to just say probably Coagulation. I liked it better than Hemorrhage, and I liked it better than Blood Gulch.
You just said a fourth map. You just named three maps, and then you said, okay, well, I have to say Coagulation.
Yeah.
And that's a fourth. You didn't even pick one of the three that you said.
No. I was just trying to think. Like, okay. I was just thinking. But, okay. Why the cat? My cowboy cat. The reason why Cowboy Cat, I don't know. I've just always...
They might not
originally
know that's from... Which Halo did you start off?
Started off in Halo 3. I think that was the first Cowboy Cat emblem.
And
like,
was it you and Nick? You and Eli Whitney?
Halo 2, I had the Mark of Shame emblem. And I think so, yeah. And then it was me and Nick, my actual friend and stuff. I'm pretty sure this is it.
I think we just did the cowboy cat,
and that's what we've always... I did the cowboy hat because of the fact that I live
people.
In Texas and stuff. Even though I don't wear cowboy hats, it's just, I don't know, I like them.
Well, and y'all both are cat people.
Yeah, and we are cat people.
Like, we don't have a cat.
And
but,
so, I used to. Yeah. But, so, yeah, that's how I just liked it, and I always stuck with it. And now, 343, there's actually a puma. Or Panther, whatever, in there. And so I'm like, are they trying to tempt me to try something new here? You know, because it's still a cat.
They don't have your original cat?
They do.
Cat?
Oh. But they always have that. And I was like, I'm going to have to try to just match up the cowboy hat and that, you know, and just see what it looks like with it. I'm not going to change it just because I like my original.
But were other people doing
still.
Cowboy cats? Were other...
Yeah, there's other... Yeah. There's other people we catch that have cowboy cats.
I mean, y'all just liked the...
Yeah, we just liked it. But, okay, next question. Blue Impulse. For Lad Duquesne, what is your gaming setup like? Can you cut to a clip or a photo? Also, do you have a forging tutorial series for MCC, or have you thought about it? I had thought about doing a racing type of forging tutorial, because I kind of did that a little bit with, like, me streaming, I did enjoy it, so I might actually do something with that. Because I'm going to be coming out with a lot of content for Master Chief Collection. Like, you know, forging stuff, custom maps, you know, something really secret that I'm really excited about on the custom map.
That's another thing you like doing, is you like showing other people how to take full advantage of what's all the features that are available. However, I mean, you got to realize there's a lot of people that ask him questions or ask him, hey, come look at my map, or hey, come ask.
And the deal is, I feel terrible whenever I say, I'm sorry, you know, I'm not going to, like, whenever they ask me to come check out their map. And the reason why, guys...
He gets asked a lot.
But the reason why I say no, it's not because I don't want to go see your map. I do. Please, just, like, tell me to, like, what map it is, and I'll go download it, or submit it on Forge channel or something like that, and I'll go download it, like, you know, post it on there. It's just that I don't want to see it with you, because just in case there's issues, or if I don't really like the map too much, like, you know, like where I'm not going to showcase it, I can't, I'm too nice of a person. I can't, like, it's so hard for me to...
Like you give nice critiques.
Yes, but some people can take even nice critiques.
Well, another problem is you get asked so often, and we might be in the middle of, you know, just it being us or something, and you don't want to...
Most of the time I have my notifications off. So if y'all send me messages, there's a lot of times I may not see them, not because I'm like, oh, I'm better than all y'all or something.
You don't
it's
see just them
because
till later.
I get a lot of game invites. I get a lot of messages and stuff where, you know, if I do record, there's so many times I forget. And if I do have notifications on, then it pops up and like, oh, I have to re-record this whole thing.
Yeah.
You know.
And there's sometimes where it's me and him sitting on the couch and talking, and then somebody's wanting him to go look at a map. But you know,
and especially if I am forging, I turn off everything because I don't want to like be bothered type.
Anyway,
of stuff.
I just wanted to say that because you were talking about doing the tutorials. So
the
tutorials and would be a nice way for you to be able to help.
I actually used to, on my showcases, I used to actually review the map. I would have a verdict. I would have positive things and negative things. Except there's so many people.
Even though
I would give a nice way, I'd be like, you know, maybe you there's a few sections of this certain like berm or this certain jump that maybe you can tweak it just a little bit to make it a little smoother or something. I actually got some complaints by the map makers and stuff for saying stuff like that, and it's just like I'm trying to help out, and I know I'm not like godly at making maps. Like I can make decent maps, especially with my type of maps.
Well, yeah, but when someone's asking you for your opinion, you don't want to just lie because you're trying to help them make a better map in your opinion.
It's just one of those things, and I don't. It's tough for me to critique things to that person, you know, and stuff. Like I'll critique with my friends. Because I'm comfortable with them and everything, where I'll critique some of their stuff.
Yeah.
Like with God's Regret, like I told him a few things on his map, on his lift kit map. I was like, hey, maybe we need to do this on this part or whatever.
Y'all kind of do that to each other a little bit.
Yeah.
Y'all kind of critique each other's.
The thing is, we're comfortable with each other. And so I don't mind telling him, hey, we need to kind of make this a little bit smoother. Because at the starting gate, I actually adjusted some of his stuff, you know, while we're in the same game and everything, and he's totally fine with it. He was like, yeah, please, you know, if you think you can smooth something out or whatever. And I smoothed
out
some of the stuff.
And he could always change it back afterwards if you didn't like what you did.
But the deal is, and the same thing with him. I wouldn't mind him doing the same.
And that's another reason why you don't like making maps with other people, because that's another request he gets all the time is, hey, come make a map with me. And
if I don't know how good that person is at making maps,
well, even if they are good, you're very particular about how you want something to look or how
I am
you want
OCD
a map to be.
Out the wazoo. So whenever I'm making a map, if it's not precise, I feel terrible going behind someone who just placed something down and lowering it down a little bit to make it precise. I feel bad doing that. I'm like I seem like, I don't know, just an a-hole, just, you know, going around and fixing some of their stuff.
No, I mean,
you know, and I don't mind if people do that to me. You know, if something's off, I'm like, yeah, if you notice it and I don't, please, you know, please fix it and stuff. That's why I like whenever on my maps, whenever I was testing a lot of my maps, you know, my Angels and Demons maps, people gave critiques and I was like, thank you, because there's some serious issues with some things I just didn't notice.
Yeah.
But yeah. So I don't know.
Anyway, the point is the tutorial videos would be a nice way for you to help without having to
I have
take up time with each
Forge
person.
Maps. with a lot of aesthetics, and not too many people do that, especially themed wise. So I think some people would like to have see a race map forged, like, and what to do or something like that. That may be pretty good. But okay, so for Ladette Duquesne, would you rather go on a holiday to Australia with $100,000? You don't get to keep any of the money if you don't spend it all, or go around the world.
He knows me so well, because I would be like, man, I would just be as cheap as possible, and I would keep the money.
Or go around the world to three cities with only enough money to stay in a hotel and eat food. Three cities around the world.
Just anywhere in the world.
With enough money for food and hotel.
You know,
or that, go to Australia with $100,000.
You know why that's a very hard question? Because Australia is one of those places that I don't know if I'll ever get to go to.
Yeah.
Because it's another continent. Like, it, I mean, not another continent, but I mean, it is another continent, yeah. But it's so far away. I don't know.
It's on the other side of the world.
It seems more unattainable. But like, if, you know, I could see us taking a trip to Europe sometime.
Yeah.
So to me, it's like, oh my gosh.
Say hi to Moore Consul, but he's not allowed to see any of our kids because he has a dirty mouth.
So the reason why that's a hard question is because I almost want to say Australia, just because in my mind, I've always pictured that as a more unattainable trip for us to take. And the three,
even with $100,000 to be able to just go spend, but
to be able to go to a place that I've always thought, oh, I'll probably never get a chance to go there.
That'd be tough because three cities anywhere in the world.
Can I choose a city in Australia?
Yeah, anywhere in the world, three cities.
I just won't have the money.
You won't have the money, though, to buy gifts or souvenirs. It's literally just for the hotel and food.
Well, then let me answer that question. I would say the three cities with only enough money to go to the hotel and food, and let me tell you why. Because whenever we do take trips, that's usually the only thing I spend money on is a place to sleep and food.
Yeah.
I got to eat and I got to sleep.
But you can't go on...
I am cheap, so that will work.
You can't do your little shark stuff. You can't go scuba diving. That's all extra money.
That's
literally
fine.
All you can do is just walk around. You can't take a taxi or any type of thing like that.
Whenever we do take trips, how often do I spend money on doing extra
stuff? I don't know,
but
if you go to Australia with $100,000, you can buy a lot of stuff and just ship it to your house.
How often, whenever we take trips, am I looking up online to find all the free stuff we could do?
I found a loophole.
What's the loophole?
I found a loophole, guys. You go to Australia. Instead of spending the money, like the $100,000 in Australia or something like that.
But he said
Wait. You spend it on things like gold. And then you take the gold with you and you have you pretty much have $100,000 worth of gold. And then you can sell that. And you got your $100,000. Or you can keep it because gold every year gets more and more expensive. Like it keeps going up. It's a great investment. And so there you go.
Don't
you just wait 20 years and you just got so much money. Oh,
we've already answered the question. Because I am a very frugal person.
Yeah.
So whenever we do take trips, I'm always looking for what can we spend our time doing that's free, that will be really fun. Because there's always fun, free stuff to do everywhere we go.
Yeah.
Right? So even whenever we do take trips, like our road trip to Vegas, we didn't spend really any money.
No.
We didn't spend too much.
I spent money.
Like we used, I mean, just, we did, we had like
I spent money on gambling, but then I actually made more money than what
we
I
had
spent,
that
though.
Annual pass for the parks. So, I mean, we did go to a lot of parks.
Yeah, but it would have been more money if you wouldn't have had that annual
the
pass.
Card. Well, no, but that's what I'm saying. We used the card to get in for free. But I'm just saying we're always looking for stuff that we do that.
Yeah.
We're not big spenders. So I think we could do that.
Okay.
Hotel and food.
I like
we get
my gold
to go to
idea.
Three places. And we could just make Australia. Pick a city in Australia, and that would be one of
our places. But
we're
definitely not
going
to go see Blue.
Whatever city Blue lives in, that will be one of our cities.
Only if he can put another shrimp on the Barbie.
Oh, you know what? See, if we go to the city where Blue's in, we don't even have to spend money on a hotel. We'll have extra money.
There you go.
We'll camp out on your couch.
Blue hates it whenever because anytime I ever talk to him, I'm like, put another shrimp on the Barbie. He doesn't hate it, but it's like one of those things where you're like, very funny or
Has
something.
Has he seen Dumb and Dumber?
Probably.
Okay.
But yeah, he can also get us a bunch of Tim Tams.
Was there another
For
question?
Lad and Ladette Duquesne, what is your favorite color and describe a new color without using any other colors? Also, is your favorite color, if your favorite color isn't blue, I will be sad. My favorite color is blue.
Purple.
So that's a shade of blue?
Now
it
he
is.
Wants
it's
us
blue
to
and red combined.
Blue and purple. So he wants us to describe a new color without using other colors. How is that even possible? Because you would have to explain what the color would look like, wouldn't
Not
you?
Necessarily. Because you can just, what you could say is, without using any other color, so that means you can use the word color. So.
Yeah, but you can't say color of a sunflower. The color of a sunflower? But that is using another color.
No, you're not actually saying it, though.
But that's already a color.
So describe like a new color, like
create your own new color.
There isn't you can't create a color
because they all,
unless you're
they
just
all
making up
exist.
Your own thing. But yeah, the colors already exist. How can you can't create your own color because they're already all
trick question
there, or they're all absent depending on what you.
He's trying to make us babble on longer. That's what
I
you're
think
doing.
So.
You're trying to make this video longer.
I think so.
Because we can sit here and babble for a while.
We're going to the next question.
We're moving on.
So, Uncle Blueberry.
We'll say the color of happiness.
There you go.
That's our new color.
So, Uncle Blueberry.
And the color of happiness is however you
want. She's still talking about this, even though she said we're going to go on.
I told you he'd make us babble. Yeah.
So, okay. Uncle Blueberry.
Hey, Duke.
Hey, Duke. That's what he calls me. I just wanted to ask, where's my glory, man? I need some public recognition, man, but I love you anyways. Also, hi, Mrs. Duke.
Now, why Duke?
Huh? Why Duquesne. Duke?
Oh, okay.
She just got that way over her head.
Well, I hear Duke. I think John Wayne.
Oh, okay. Wow.
Okay. That's why I was just wondering where he got Duke from.
But
that makes sense.
No, the reason why he says that, this was a while ago he asked this. But the reason why he said that is because he is actually a new content producer on Forge Channel. Like, he'll do some little news things about Halo or whatever on the front cover, and he does a pretty good job. So everyone say, yay, Blueberry.
Go check it out.
Yeah, go check it out. But on a serious matter, I wanted to ask, what is your favorite Halo map of all time? We've already said
Coagulation.
This. Coagulation. And I don't mean a custom Forge map. I mean a default map in-game. You might have said this before, earlier in
we
this
just
episode.
Did. Yeah.
But for those of us that don't know me, please inform.
You have been informed.
There you go.
Okay.
Apparently, he does not read the previous questions asked on here. So do not say good job to a Blueberry. You should say... read other questions.
Pay attention.
But okay, so Captain Curlio asks, is it bad that I typically only watch Famo Fridays up until my answer is questioned? So we will skip your answer till the very end.
We'll have to save yours.
Fish Dish Films asks,
are you serious?
Yeah, I'm going to do it. Yeah. Fish Dish Films asks, how are you so awesome? You know?
He's not really that awesome.
It's because of these eyes. I do love my eyes.
It is the eyes. Okay.
Also, are you still doing a Halo MCC 1v1? If so, what map? Thanks. Because it was just like joking around and stuff. Like I was like, 1v1 me, bro, and stuff. And then we were like, yeah, doing an MCC. I guess I'll have to.
You've been challenged.
So I've been challenged. Okay. I guess I will sometime. Yeah. What map?
It's been said in the video now.
Bloodline.
Okay.
No, that's going to be too far. We can do it on, what is it? Warlord. I like Warlord. We'll do it on Warlord. Okay, so Beowulf asks with an entire page of text.
Oh my gosh, he wrote us a book.
Me mamo. first things first, happy Halloween and Kratz. Congrats on finding out, And congrats on finding out on your baby boy.
Happy Halloween
Yay.
To everybody.
Yeah, in case y'all do not know, we're having another baby boy.
Yes.
Yay.
For Halloween, we were Casey Jones.
April O'Neil.
And we had a little Leonardo.
Little Leonardo.
And if you don't know who those people are, shame on you.
Shame on you.
And look them up. April O'Neil, do not look up images because we have found out that there's some
don't
racy
look up
images
yes.
underneath April O'Neil.
Apparently, there are some... some naughty April O'Neils.
And we did not dress up like the new characters, which I don't even think Casey Jones is in the new movie. We dressed up from the original movie, which I think came out in like 86.
Something like that.
1986?
Yeah.
Those were the ones that we grew up with.
Yeah.
So, Casey Jones, April O'Neil, and Leonardo.
She had the April O'Neil. We tried to find a good...
the original
rain jacket.
Cartoon, she had the
she
full
had the
yellow
full body yellow. But we tried to find her in the movies. She had a rain jacket that was yellow, we tried to find one that was like it, but it was like $50, and it's like.
So my costume just consisted of a yellow jacket
or something.
But anyway, yeah. Andrew looked pretty awesome, but, and so did Aiden. So
I'll throw a picture.
You'll
probably
see some pictures.
So, yeah. All right. So it's been a while since I asked a question. So prepare yourself for lengthy questions for you to discuss. To Duguesne, as soon as I seen the news on the Halo 2 Anniversary Forge, I automatically assumed you were drooling over it. But after seeing all the things added, it really has me excited for the custom game community. Halo 4's custom games were decent because there were some pretty unbelievable maps made in there. But to me, it wasn't as fun as Reach, which I would agree with that. I would agree. But one thing that really has me wondering is if we are going to see something new this time around from Forgers and what this means on Halo 5's Forge, since they have added, you know, since what they have added in Halo 2 Anniversary. What do you hope to see in Forge for Halo 5, and what are some things you would like to see more from on the Forging community? Now, There's some mess ups with Beowulf and stuff, just because he even told me while he was talking, he was playing while typing all this out, and he was like, I'm trying to play and talk to y'all and type this at the same time. So there's gonna be some screw ups, you know, or stuff. But
so you had to be careful on how you answer this, because you don't want to give away what you're most excited about.
Like, I seriously, and it's something, guys.
Don't overhype it.
I'm not gonna. It's pretty exciting.
Stop doing that.
It's pretty exciting.
Stop doing that. There are some really neat features that they have in the Halo 2 Forge.
Yeah.
And the thing is, as amazing as it was in Reach, and even in Halo 4 and in 3, it's gonna to be amazing with the new features and with the new objects and everything, what people are going to be able to do
in the terrain pieces, the console and the switches that you can, you know, script, you know, certain objects, like you can script the fusion coils to blow up, or, you know, script a charge off an EMP, open up a door, you know, because think about it, like with racing, like let's say you're racing with a Gun Goose, you have a Gun Goose race, you can shoot like a switch ahead, and that can cause something behind you to go off. Normally, what you would have to do is put a landmine on the ground, and then you would have to have fusion coils lining all the way down to where you're triggering something behind you. So you run over that, and it triggers something behind you. Now you could shoot it ahead of time and trigger it. Or you could shoot ahead of time, and a door could start shutting, and you can get through the door into a shortcut or something like that.
The thing is, with the even with the lack of features that the other ones had, people still find ways, like you said, I remember you coming up with like little booby traps and stuff like that. And it's amazing to see what people can come up with whenever they don't even have the features.
Yeah.
So like, the fact that they're giving those features, it's
where you can actually have doors opening
people always go beyond what the developer is really intending. So people will find amazing things to do.
You can literally build the Forge world. If you look at their little four island complex, that's enough to build a Forge world, like Halo Reach's Forge world in, you know, this Forge. Like, that is insane if you think about it. You can actually build a Halo Reach's Forge world in this. That's crazy.
We can't wait to see what people...
Yeah, it's going to be unbelievable.
It's just like with Trials, with Project Spark.
Oh my gosh,
all these games that they're coming out with...
It's ridiculous.
I mean, they've been out for a while, some of these, but it's just amazing what people are
able to do that type of stuff,
And the stuff they're able to make, It's going to be...
We'll definitely see some new stuff
in... Halo's moving towards that, too.
In Master Chief Collection. We'll definitely see some new stuff in Halo 2 Anniversary. I have something that's brand new, that's a great idea from Nick. He told me. And it's like... We were brainstorming it and, you know, expanding upon it and stuff. And it's an unbelievable idea. Like, seriously, it has never been done before. It is somewhat of a game changer type of thing. Like, it's very interesting, and I'm super excited to be able to do this. And I was planning on just doing like a race map first or something. I might do this first because I'm so excited about it. So, here we go. What else do we have? Halo 5's Forge. Oh, stuff that they could possibly add with Halo 5's Forge, since they have added all these terrain pieces. All this stuff will be in Halo 5's Forge.
Yeah.
Aren't they building, I think they're building a new engine for Halo 5. I'm not exactly sure on that, so don't take that, you know, but I thought sometime they mentioned that, that they're going to have a new engine and stuff for Halo 5. If not, oh well, but I'm just saying, I thought so, but, the deal is it could be more powerful or whatever. Like, they could optimize the Xbox One better to where you can even have more Forge stuff. Possibly throwing in some things like weather effects in there. That would be nice. Or a time of day thing where you can adjust the time of day. That would be really cool.
Yeah, they haven't mentioned any of that with Halo 2, but we don't
know. I don't think that would be in there. There's too much in Halo 2 already because there's four games.
Yeah.
You know. But okay, so to Lady Decaying, there's a lot of food out there that people eat that others think is absolutely nasty.
They're saying the same stuff.
Yeah, but this is just like tripe or bugs or whatever. One thing I really like that a lot of people find disgusting is squid or calamari.
Ooh, I love calamari.
I wouldn't eat squid raw though.
No.
You know.
Oh no, because even over in certain areas, they eat them alive.
Yeah, so is there any food you have eaten that's unappetizing to other people?
You have to have it wrapped really you have to have it wrapped a certain way or it can like try to crawl back and it can actually kill you.
But I love calamari too. Yeah, calamari, I love calamari. I love raw oysters.
Yeah, a lot of people don't like that. I mean, I'd rather have them fried, but...
But you got to eat them with months in an R because it's got to be in winter months.
I've had escargot, like snails.
I don't think I've ever had escargot.
And it was pretty good. I had it with like some butter sauce. And yeah. I'm willing to try a lot of things. And I guess some people would think that's gross. Like I said earlier, I've had like rabbit and squirrel. And
also, this goes into this. What other foods do you try or never touch? I would try escargot and stuff.
You know, I've kind of wanted to try it. But the only time I've been offered to try it, the person had bought it at like some like food truck or some, and I wasn't gonna go there. But menudo.
Yeah.
If you don't know, no, it's like pig intestines, I believe.
Oh, I thought it was brain.
It's a Hispanic, isn't it? It's like a Hispanic dish, and it's like soup. But
I would eat brains and stuff.
I'm pretty sure it's like pig entrails.
I'd try it.
A lot of people really love menudo. And I wanted to try good menudo, but like I said, the one time I got offered it, I didn't trust the place that it came from.
I would try most everything if it was dead. Like, the stuff that's still moving, you know,
I've had chicken feet.
Yeah.
Not saying that I really enjoyed it, but I had chicken feet. A lot of people would think that's gross. Yeah, I guess a lot of people find the squirrel.
Chickens are
a lot of people find the squirrel really strange, but you know I grew up squirrel hunting, and we would eat the squirrel, and it's not like eating a rat. They eat nuts. It's good meat. It's not like eating.
It's just like eating anything, like a rabbit.
Yeah, I like rabbit.
But I don't know. I've had alligator and all that type of stuff. That's good.
I don't think I've ever had snake.
Frog legs.
But I've wanted to try snake.
I think I've had snake before in Boy Scouts, and that
was
pretty good.
I've had frog legs, and I'm not a big fan.
I'm not a big fan of frog legs. I don't know. I would try most everything.
You wouldn't try the chicken feet.
I tried
getting you to eat the chicken
feet. The reason why I wouldn't try chicken feet is because, for one thing, it's chicken feet. And for another thing, there is literally no meat to it. It's literally like just...
I mean, it's like chewing meat off of like a rib or off of a...
Yeah, except that the meat is literally like a millimeter, like...
The meat's like in their... Like in the... I guess it's kind of like their palm.
I would try it if I was starving, but you know...
You have to eat quite a bit of chicken... few chicken feet to
I would
get
try
meat.
Most things, but there are probably some things I'm good, but still.
I'm sure, sheep eyeballs... I don't know if I would eat. You know how like that's a delicacy. Some people eat like sheep eyeballs.
Oh, he was saying also things like a lot of people don't like mushrooms or whatever. Things like eating fungus, like blue cheese, because blue cheese is pretty much mold in the cheese.
I don't like mushrooms because of the flavor, not because
I don't like mushrooms because of the flavor. My mom always puts mushrooms inside spaghetti, and there's a lot of times I would eat it.
Oh yeah,
but it's just that's because I don't actually taste the flavor. Yeah. But, and I know they're there, I just eat them, but if I have it, like, by itself, I just don't,
I'm the same way. I can have it with other stuff, but some people like just having mushrooms.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I don't like the way it tastes. I've tried it several times, several different types of mushrooms. I don't really like the way it tastes.
I don't like pickles, but I love pickle juice on my Chick-fil-A sandwiches.
Blue cheese? I would eat blue cheese just fine.
I would try it. I think I have had it, but I just don't like it.
Yeah.
It's very strong.
Well, that's what I was about to say. I don't really care for it too much.
We got to get to the next one because this is a long video.
I know.
This is going to take me like 12
they
hours.
They keep asking us about food.
This is going to come out on Monday because this has to render for 12
here's
hours.
Here's a warning. Anytime you ask us about food, I could go on for a long time about food because I love food.
To both Duquesne and Lady Duquesne, Star Wars has been in so many different ways, such as miniseries like Rebels and Clone Wars. And there are even video games like Battlefront and Force Unleashed.
Mm-hmm.
Is there any TV shows or movie that you would want to see be made the same way? Maybe a video game into a movie or TV series like Halo is doing. My personal option, I would really like Mass Effect movie or TV show. And the universe is so rich and vast that there's a lot of potential to see something be made. Yes, Mass Effect would be pretty awesome.
For a TV series. For a long-running TV series. Yeah, there's a lot you could do with that.
That would be pretty good.
Of course, we would love to see a Halo movie.
Of
course.
But the deal is, with the Halo movie, though, it would have to come in parts. And I don't want them to stray from... Like, I don't want the director to be like, I want to do my own thing, M. Night Shyamalan with The Last Airbender.
Which, actually, I think Halo makes a great TV show, too, because Ford Unto Dawn was great.
Unbelievable. And Halo Nightfall looks awesome, too.
They could follow ODST.
There's
so much they could do with that. They could be miniseries where they could follow different...
I would actually... Halo ODST is one of my favorite Master Halo Chief. Games because of the fact that you aren't overpowered,
mm-hmm.
you know? And so that would be really interesting to follow. And, Agent Locke, you know, he's actually starts out as... Like, he's not a Spartan and stuff. Like, in Nightfall, he's not a Spartan and stuff.
There's been a lot of stuff I myself have been interested in that I wish that I could learn more about the story or see more. Like, Master Chief's, origin.
The
Doctor with his, of
with
Halsey,
his group, his little, his group and everything. About. Who's his group? Like, I don't remember everyone, but I know, I think Linda is in there. That's one chick.
They've referenced stuff about his history and stuff like that, but I think that would make an amazing story.
I don't
story.
Know a lot about the lore beyond the games and, like, if there's
TV
things.
Oh, yeah, they
have
the books.
They have the books and stuff. Yeah. I started reading the books. I got tired of reading. They were interesting. If I had an audiobook, I'd probably listen to it. But it's just that, yeah.
I'm sure it would be great in TV form.
Yeah.
Same thing, like I said, following the ODST. Like, whenever they do their live-action trailers,
that one ODST live-action trailer was ridiculous.
What really makes me want, like, oh my gosh, I wish we could keep watching.
It had, like, that Russian, the Russian type of deal or something like that. I don't know, just some other language. I think it was something.
I know exactly what you're
talking
about.
But it was speaking, and that music was playing in the background. It's so strong. They had the battle rifle shooting.
And it's so well made. It's like,
it was unbelievable.
It's like, whoever made that, make a TV show, make a movie.
And that one short little trailer where Cat's running with the bomb and everything, Reach, and it's playing that,
watching those little trailers, does make me crave.
So strong. That trailer with Cat carrying the bomb is so strong because she gets blown up, and then all of a sudden the rookie comes
picks
up there
up
and picks
and
it
goes,
up and goes flying off to
so
deal.
Great.
It's giving me tingles right now. That's how strong I'm literally having tingles going down,
that's
my spine
saying,
and stuff
that,
right now thinking about it. It's unbelievable.
But of course, those are obvious answers.
Yeah.
I mean, is there something obscure that people might not think about? Something like Borderlands
I would
or Fallout.
Really,
or,
I know this isn't something that is probably done. Fallout would be really good to do.
I wouldn't say this is something extremely obscure,
but I would really like to see Beyond Good and Evil.
Made into a movie, or a TV show. You think?
A TV show. I think that would be kind of cool.
I'd be on the fence about that one.
You know? I think it could be done where it's not like an unbelievable TV show, something, something like Smallville or something where it's a good TV show, it's not unbelievable, but it's still good.
It would be harder to pull off.
Yeah.
Because there's not as much going
That's something obscure that I think I would like to be able to see.
So we keep talking about video games going into TV shows. Are there any TV shows or movies that you can think of?
The what?
That would be good? to make a video game of.
To make a video game.
You know what
of,
movie I we haven't seen
it? They do for
it?
Everything.
You know what movie? No, they do the other way around. They make a lot of movies based off of video games.
No, but they make a lot of video games based every single movie that comes
like
out.
The Walking
like,
Dead.
They have a video game.
I usually don't
No,
like
but that video game is actually really good by Telltale.
I didn't say it was. I'm just
but
saying.
It's different,
lot,
though. It's not.
A lot
not,
of that stuff doesn't
not,
do well.
It's not like the TV show, though.
A lot of that stuff doesn't do well. But you know what movie I'm thinking of right now? And it's that Tom Cruise one, the Die, Repeat. Live, Die, Repeat.
Edge of Tomorrow.
Edge of Tomorrow. To me, that would make a good video game.
That would be an interesting video game. Yeah, if they do it well.
Now, I'm saying that we have not seen the movie.
People say it's a good movie.
I am simply saying that from the preview, it looks like that would
be... Guardians of the Galaxies, I think, would be... And that's a unbelievable... I think if you do it right,
that
could
be a
great...
We need a Lego Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yes. Which they're in Lego Marvel,
watching?
Aren't they? But it's still not same.
Who's,
it's not same.
Who am I talking to? Are you watching?
Yeah. But we need a,
we
but
need
a Guardians of the Galaxy like
Galaxy
video game, but well done.
A Lego movie.
You know, would be
I mean,
really
a Lego
good.
A Lego game.
But okay,
anyway.
We got to get to the next one.
Yeah.
So maybe video game, my personal. But okay, we're good. All right, so Phantom Lucario asks, "Oh man, so many questions have been asked. I don't know what to ask." Oh, I know. Thank you for writing all that. have you ever been to Geek and Sundry, which is located in California? Never been to California.
No.
I've been practically everywhere in central U.S., a little bit west and a little bit east and stuff, like all the way to like Arizona west-wise, you know, type of thing, and all the way to West Virginia.
No, you've been farther than Arizona. You've been in Nevada.
Nevada, yeah. And, sorry about that. Yeah, Nevada. And, but I've been like to West Virginia and Tennessee, east side, but I haven't actually been on the coasts of either side.
Yeah, I've been in Nevada to Florida.
Yeah.
I mean, not.
And
not,
I've been everywhere up. I've been up. I've been
into
Montana,
in
and of course, I live in Texas, so that's.
I've been
in
Missouri. No, yeah, Missouri.
Yeah. But
isn't
okay.
That, isn't
so.
That, that's kind of north. Northeast? Mm. Is that northeast of us?
Yeah.
Missouri?
Yeah. Okay, so...
But no, no California. Do we know what Geek and Sundry...
No,
what was it
don't
called?
Have a clue what it is.
Oh, you'll have to tell us what that is.
But all right, so now back to Captain Curlio's question.
Are you still with us?
Yeah. See, this is an hour in almost.
Actually,
so.
didn't we already... Didn't he ask
no,
more than
hold
one question?
On. No, he didn't. No. Also, please tell me if you're as pumped for Master Chief Collection as I am. No one at my school is excited for it, and it frustrates me because I have no one to talk to about it. Are you serious? You didn't even ask a question after that? So we waited the entire time to ask your
and
question.
And he's probably not even watching.
And he's probably laughing right now like,
no,
I didn't ask a question after that.
He's probably not even watching.
I know. He's probably, oh my gosh.
He's already,
are you kidding me?
He's
he didn't
already
even
bailed
ask
out.
A question. But yes, I am just excited as you are. Probably more excited. But all right, guys. This is a ridiculously long video. It's going to take forever to render out, but oh well.
I hope y'all stayed through it to the
yes.
end.
Yes. If you did stay to it till the end, I want to thank you. And also, I would like to just say... stay tuned to Forge Channel because there might be a contest going up soon.
And you're our favorites because
yeah,
you stayed.
You're our favorites. If you did stay till the end, write Forge a New Halo.
Forge a New Halo.
That's Forge Channel's motto.
Oh, okay.
Forge a New Halo.
Forge a New Halo.
So write
so
that in
the
comments if you stayed till the end. Like, you don't have to just write that, but somewhere in your comment, write Forge a New Halo. So we see who stayed.
Oh.
Who stayed the whole
I'm
hour.
I'm going to be sad if we don't even see one.
I know. Yes. Yeah, but I'm sure we'll get one guy.
It was a long video.
I'm sure we'll get one guy clicking all the way till the end, you
and
know?
And he just happens to catch it.
And he just happens
like,
to hear that. And he's like,
them.
Got it. I didn't have to watch the entire 59 minutes before this.
Or somebody's going to see Forge a New Halo a couple of times and go,
and they're
gonna
be,
what's that?
What's that?
They're
I'm
going
to type it.
They're going to click to the end. Yeah. Yeah, they're just going to type it. Anyway.
But okay, guys.
If you stayed with us, thanks for
yeah.
bearing
thanks for watching.
The hour.
Because we ramble on a lot. But I know that's what a lot of people have asked if we should cut it down.
And
stuff,
no.
And they said no. They like that we ramble and talk
hey,
about our opinions.
Hey, whenever
and stuff.
You start asking us about food, you have just
food or Halo.
Yeah.
Get a Coke
or Star Wars.
Just get
pop
a Coke.
Some popcorn.
You know, just get a Coke. Get some popcorn.
We could
grab
keep,
some Oreos
we
and Tim
talking.
Tams.
We could keep. I mean, we
just,
are. We are
know.
Still talking.
And for Thai okay. boy, you know, get some nachos.
We'll see y'all later.
But all right, guys.
We're leaving now.
Go to Forge Channel. Ask another question, guys.
Happy Halloween.
And yeah, happy Halloween. And I hope y'all enjoy this. Oh, and we'll see y'all next time. And what?
Let's ask them a question. What did you dress up as?
What did you dress up as? And if you did,
what did you do?
And if you did dress up as something,
did you go trick-or-treating?
If you don't mind showing a picture of it,
oh, yeah.
Go to Imgur or Imgur, whatever, and upload your, you know, screenshot of whatever your, you know, dress, your outfit that you did, upload mm-hmm. it to there, and give me the link in the comment, and so we can check out some of your
outfits.
We could
post them on Facebook if you want to.
Yeah. There
we
you
could
go.
Do that.
We can, yeah, we can do that. So
we'll see. What are your fans called? Duquesne or Kitty or Cowboy Kitties?
Yeah.
What are we calling them?
They're my Cowboy Kitties.
We can post some Cowboy Kitties dressed up on,
there you go.
On Facebook. The fans.
That's, 1 year, I really have to do that.
The Halloween.
No one would get it.
No, do what?
A cowboy cat.
Oh, no, nobody would get that. But anyway, yeah.
I'm gonna do that one.
So we want
to
know.
Except I would have to get the face. I would look like Hey Arnold.
So we want to know if you.
Or Stewie.
If you dressed up for Halloween, what'd you dress up as and what did you do? Did
there you go.
Trick or treating or did you go party?
There you go.
Or pass out candy.
Or pass out.
Some of you might have.
So you never know.
Okay.
But okay, guys. Thanks for watching. And we'll see y'all next time.
Bye.
Later.